Welcome to our month of Soul Food Movements. Today's posture is half pigeon. Half pigeon is one of my favorite postures. There's 100 different ways to take it. I'm going to show you a few modified versions and then we'll get into the real half pigeon in just a moment. So to start on your back. If you're close to a wall or there's a pillar in class, you're welcome to use that as well. But you're going to cross your ankle over your knee. So take your right ankle over your left knee. And notice there if you can feel anything on the outside of your hip open up for you. If not, you'll just hug in. So I like to keep the feet nice and activated, toes being pulled to your shins. And then from here, there's a few options. You can actively press your knee away, so towards the wall, other wall. Or you can take your hand and help press it away as well. You should feel the opening on the outside of whatever leg is bent up into the air. And then you're just using a little bit of counterforce to hug in with the opposite knee as you press the opposite knee away. You can use same thing with the wall. You're just going to bring your booty. The closer your booty is to the wall, the more intense the stretch is going to be. You want to come up, again, cross, toes are activated. And from here, try and let your hips fall to the ground as, again, you press your knee away from your face. It's the same thing if you did it seated, right here. Same thing. Awesome. But to come into the full version of half pigeon, start in downward facing dog. So from downward facing dog, inhale your right foot high, and then exhale, you're going to bring your right ankle behind your left wrist, and then your right knee behind your right wrist. From there, I don't need you to be in a straight line. You definitely don't need to be parallel with the mat. I like to bring whatever ankle is up to the opposite hip flexor. So from there, you can play with your knee and your shin being at a little bit of an angle. I always want your knee more outside your body. So if you come down and you're laying right on top of your knee, I want you to bring it outside just a little bit more so that the heel is really in line with that hip flexor tucked in. And if that feels easy, then you can try and bring your shin a little bit more parallel to the front of your mat. Look back at your left foot. Your toes should be on the ground. A lot of the times we see a crooked foot here. So I want your toes nice and flat, big toe grounds down. You should have a little bit of internal rotation. This is a really good assist for teachers. Internal rotation of the back leg because we have a ton of external rotation in the front leg. So it just helps you find a little bit of balance in your hips. Really think about lifting yourself up to square through your hips. So usually you need to pull the right hip back as you bring the left hip forward and then square your chest. From there, you can start to walk your hands out. You can come onto your forearms, bring your hands down, place your head on top of your hands, or you can come all the way down. If this feels okay, you can play with bringing your hands behind your back. If you want to thread the needle, you leave your whatever knee is bent, that same arm stays up. The opposite hand comes up and underneath. Reach up and around with that same hand. Play with trying to keep the hips nice and square. Play with trying to really relax and send a lot of breath to the outside of whatever hip is bent. If you need a little bit of help, the block is a beautiful tool here. Whatever leg is up front, I want you to take the block under that hip, and then it's kind of just like a little seat for you. So you can still keep the hips nice and square to the front, but it's not so much intense on the front of your knee or on your hip either. If there's any knee pain in this pose, which a lot of the times there are, try a block. If the block is not enough, come to one of our modified poses because that's going to be the best thing and safest thing for you now. So play with half pigeon. It's one of my favorite postures. It's a great way to open. It's a great one to just sit and breathe in, one to add to your morning and your nighttime routine. Thank you.